Phil. It's nice meeting you.
Thank you.
We're from the Deeper Life Bible Church. We just came around to do a quick tour and capture the work that is going on here for our congregants. I hope you don't mind taking us around and explaining to us what is happening and what the individual areas are meant for.
Yeah, no problem. Only my pleasure.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Thank you. At the moment, we're at front stalls, which is the front of the auditorium. Behind us is the stage where your baptismary pool will be put in, which I'm sure you'll get a look. If you follow me around, you'll see that that's your baptistry pool that will be going, that will be submerged into the stage that we've extended out. Behind the stage, as you'll see above us, is your air handling units and acoustic enclosure that has been built with offices and stores, showers on east and west elevations. Seating capacity in front stalls to where I am now, you'd probably look at a total seating capacity of 2,500. So you're probably looking at about 200-300 seats just in this area where I am now, leading up to that first face of the front stalls. As you probably know, it's a grade 2 listed building, and obviously we've had to keep into that specific thing. So all the colors and textures have been maintained to suit the grade 2 list of the former Granada Cinema, which is now going to be DCLM. Right, so we're just going to move our way up to the sensor stalls, which is another seated area that's probably going to hold probably another 200 seats and more. So we'll just make our way up there, and then when we get there, we'll explain what we got. Okay. Right, so here we are. We're in the sensor stalls, which was going to be a seated capacity of about another 200 seats. It's going to be stackable chairs. To where you're facing now, that's going to be one of your serveries, which is a kitchen that you're going to be serving food and drink from that side, and then going into a storeroom and some toilets through there. Female toilets are going through that door there. If you make your way around this way again, you'll see we'll go to the other elevation, which is the west side of the building, which is another servery, another serving point for food and drink, coffees, teas, so on and so forth. Again, all colors are to what the grade 2 list was, which is the original colors of the building. Okay. Not much happening on this other than carpeted areas. All these areas are going to be carpeted with a broad loom carpet, which I'll show you as we get up to the next elevation to see what your decorative decoration or design of your carpet that you've chosen. So if we make our way up there, we'll tell you about what's going on up here. Okay, so here we are, rear auditorium, ground floor. I'm just going to show you a sample of the carpet that's going to be going in here, which is going to be this is the design of your broad loom carpet that is going to be installed right the way through the building, rear stores, center stores, and front stores. This is the same carpet as well that will be going above us in the tiered upper and lower balcony. Right, another area that's going to be for chairs and seated area. Probably another 200-250 chairs that could possibly go in here. Okay. Along each tier, there's going to be a glass handrail, glass and brass handrail in front of us. Along this edge is going to be a brass and glass handrail. Okay. Mirror image here to the next elevation, and then up each side of the staircases to the stage. Okay. Behind us is the lobbies that go through to your entrance and the foyer of the building. These are all fire doors and fire exits that will take you through or out of the building. Coming around along the top on that side of the wall, we've got male and female WCs, toilets, and so on and so forth, going down the passage into the main kitchen. Okay, and that probably concludes this area as where we are now. Okay. As you can see all the decorative works, original features of the building in terms of the leafing and cornice and colors. above us, if you stay to that elevation, you've got a folding wall that's going to be installed next week, Monday, which will be dividing this, so you can have different functions or different things that you do with closing that wall. And then it's going to be subdivided again by another wall, another folding wall. It's going to project across this area here. So you're going to have a folding wall here and a main folding wall along there. So effectively, this could be two separate areas. Reason, you know. Okay. Total capacity down here in terms of seating are between 1,500 and 1,700 seats just on the ground floor. Okay. Okay, so here we are. We're going into one of your surveys just on the installation of your worktops, water heaters, so on and so forth. So if you'd like to come with me through to the room, and I'll take you through what is actually happening here. Right. Yeah, right, here we are in the foyer where you can see the cleaning of the terrazzo flooring that is the original feature of the building, which again we have to maintain and make good.
This place is beautiful.
Yeah. So we're making our way up onto the balcony area. This area has got a capacity of 900 seats, which is rather large, but rather impressive as well. Right, so this is the middle of the upper and lower balcony. In front of us, down below, is the stage area where we've just been. So you can see how close these people will be to the stage in terms of this balcony. As you can see, what we've got on the floor at the moment is the underlay starting to go down for the broadloom carpet that's going to be going in to this area. You can see the operatives working up above us. So here we are in the upper passage of the upper balcony, where we've got staircase 4 and 5 from ground floor that lead up to this area. So you've got access from first floor onto the balcony and then up the staircases, second floor onto the top of the balcony here. This all again is going to be broadloom carpet right across to the far side where you have executive offices, meeting room, and we go down another staircase where there's showers. This is female toilets, okay, where there's also a shower room and vinyl flooring that's going in here with cubicles and toilets. You'll see in the uniqueness about this one is that we've got a shower in here. With 4 basins, mirrors, so it's rather nice. Right, and it's going to take you out into one of our acoustic enclosures. Now, this has been built for 2 chillers, external chillers, and these are the main units that air condition this whole building. So if we come through with me, and then we go into air handling unit 8 of the 10 that you've got in the building, okay? And this is an extract, believe it or not, from the main ground floor. You know where your 2 serveries are? This one sucks out air from underneath those and pushes it out into the atmosphere. So this is the waste air, if you want to call it as that, yes? And then, unfortunately, this is also classed as a fire route for the apartments above us, which is why we've had to put this door here, because if there's a case of there's a fire in the apartments above us, they've got to be able to escape through here. So I'll show you that. as we go through. Yes, yeah. So here we are on the escape route for the apartments above us. Okay. Unfortunately, they have to come through this way. Take you up onto third floor roof where you've got air handling unit 10 and some more mechanical stuff that's coming via the crane. So if we make our way up staircase 2. Right, show you the top of staircase 2 and we're going to be going out onto the third floor roof. Yeah, but I'm going to take you down the staircase now. So I'm going to take you down staircase 2 where we're going to show you the executive office, executive shower point, T point, and the various AV stores and AV rooms as we go down. And then we'll get right down to the bottom where the main kitchen will be, which is still works in progress, but I'll show you where that is going to be. Right, we're coming down to the bottom of staircase 2, which is your fire exit, which will lead out onto Plough Road. Again, it's going to be non-slip paint on this fire exit. It's a special paint that we're putting on this that stops you from slipping, believe it or not. Yeah. And as we go down, we make our way out to where your main kitchen is going to be, where you'll do majority of your cooking. Yeah, and then you'll take it out to the different serveries and then serve from there. And this is going into your main kitchen. Okay. We can come through if you want, yes. Okay, this floor is going to be latexed and have a grey vinyl on it. Okay, you can see some of your stuff is going to have gone in already, which is called a condensed hood. And this is for your dishwasher. You know, when you open a dishwasher, all the steam comes out. Well, this catches the steam. A condensed, no, it doesn't. It doesn't got no extraction. It catches the steam. That turns into water, and the water runs down the side of the thing, and then you just drain it from here. So it's called a condensed hood. It's quite clever, but it stops the steam going out into the room, and then this is where majority of your cooking is going to be. You've got a three-phase cooker and worktops, which you'll see as we're going out, that are all boxed up, ready to go in. Just got to get the floor right. Right, for the audio-visual side of it, you're going to have an audio-visual desk, an AV desk, which is in the front stores. All the cables are running up and coming through the floor into the desk, where that's where all your operatings will be.